In this video, we will review the traffic analytics feature of the Bequant node. So traffic analytics are based on metrics of some traffic flows. Traffic flows are sampled. For a percentage of them, usage data records will be generated into disk. If there are some client IP addresses of special interest, you can configure them, and 100% of the flows of those configured IP addresses will generate the usage data records. Those usage data records are processed by the system and generate a service composition over time report and also service composition total. We will see the details later on. The system also generates traffic usage for client IP address, and it does so for all client IPs. And based on that information, generates a report of traffic consumption per client over time, and also the totals per client. In the next section, we will see the configuration and the aspects of those reports. Let's see how to configure analytics parameters. The first one is in TCP acceleration, configuration acceleration for historical reasons, is the percentage of data flows that will generate usage data records. A normal value is 2%. For example, if your throughput is up to 10 gigabit per second, if you have less throughput, let's say 100 megabit per second, you might want to increase this percentage. If there is some specific client IP addresses of interest, you go to analytics configuration, add IP address, and you can here put IP addresses of clients that you are interested. 100% of the data flows of those clients will generate the data records. Let's say that these two customers have been complaining about quality, and you want to understand better the service composition of those clients to support them in a better way. So let's see analytics reports. They are in analytics statistics. There are four reports. Let's go to DPI hourly, the first one. So if you click there, it will take some time to process the usage data records, and it will show for the last day the evolution over time of the traffic composition. So it shows you a number of domains and also IP addresses if the domain is unknown. You can also show last 2 days, up to 3 days of data is available. You can, if you want, filter the graphic to see only one specific category, to revert back to all of them. You can extend number of categories to up to 30. This will be the ones that contribute more to the traffic. You can reduce the categories to the main five, filter per direction. So for example, uplink direction from clients to content servers. Obviously, it's a different service composition than the one that you will see in the downlink in many networks. And you can filter per IP address. So if let's say you already configured previously in analytics configuration an IP address, you can come here and see exactly what that user was doing. Also, you can have totals, not just evolution over time, of service composition with exactly the same options regarding the number of days, number of categories, the direction of the traffic, and also the possibility of filtering per IP address. In subscribers hourly, it will show usage in terms of traffic volume, not composition per service, but which IP addresses, client IP addresses, are the heaviest users. So you can, for example, narrow to some range of interest to see exactly which IPs are consuming most of the traffic at any given time. You can do also the same, but filtering per traffic direction, because sometimes, well, the heaviest downlink user is not the same as the heaviest uplink. And if you want, you can also filter per IP address. First, you can also use ranges. Let's say in this case we do ranges, and we just filter IPs from that subnet. Subscribers total, the same. So it's traffic usage, not over time, but all aggregated for the period that we are considering, last day in this case. You can filter per direction, and that's all. More videos are available in our YouTube channel and website.